amazing feature in Teams meetings to improve the way you communicate. It's called Speaker Coach. You don't require any special license. It's available to every user of Teams. All that you have to do is, in a meeting, go and enable the feature. That's all. Now it's going to listen to what you're saying, the way you are saying, how you're participating, and then it's going to analyze and check, can you improve something? And if it does find something, it's going to prompt you live. You will see messages like this. For example, speed up, don't use this phrase, that's offensive, and so on. It also gives you a detailed report after the meeting is over. And that is a revelation. Even if you are great at communication, there may be some mistakes you are doing. And the more senior you are, the lesser is the chance that someone is going to point out your mistakes. So this is how the report looks. First time you go to a report, enable this setting which says automatically start it in every meeting. That way you don't worry about forgetting to enable it manually. It gives suggestions under six categories. And probably the most common mistake is repetitive language. These are the words which are part of sentences, but for whatever reason, we use the same word again and again. So this is a session I have conducted for 1.5 hours, 2 hours almost, and I uttered this word for 53 times. I may not have noticed it, but the audience will. So it's not just highlighting problems, it's telling you how to solve it. So it's saying, whenever you're feeling like saying also, why don't you use some other words? Additionally, furthermore, moreover, next time you're in the meeting, you have to consciously start thinking about what am I going to speak and then speak. Then there's another kind of problem called filler words. They are not a part of a sentence. They are between two sentences or topics. And generally, what does it mean? When we use filler words like, I mean, those kind of things, that means I'm thinking. Filler words are bad because your audience understands that you're thinking or you're not very thorough with the subject. So here it just gives you a tally. It also tells you, you said basically here. Okay, you know I said here. So, and then try to correlate when this is happening and consciously try to avoid it. The next one is pace. In videos, when you're watching, at least you can speed up. But in a live meeting, you are really bored. On the other side, some people speak very fast, and by the time they finish one topic, there's no pause, they start another topic, and the audience is just grappling with what is really happening. So too fast, too slow, bad. But typically, we are talking about 100 to 160 words per minute being the correct speed. In some cases, it may even be okay to slow down because you want to emphasize on something. The other one is monologue. Now, in my case, because most of the sessions I do are one-way sessions where I'm demonstrating, explaining, coaching, it does sound as monologue. But even then, it has given me only 4 instances where I must have spoken for a really long time without any pauses. In order to avoid monologues, you can do polls. You can ask questions to audience. You can take question breaks periodically and do some Q&A. Basically, break the monotony. Then we have inclusiveness. This is an interesting one. So people are very sensitive about many things. It could be gender or age or race, geopolitical references, disabilities. Here, somewhere in this, I said master. We use along with master-slave architecture kind of thing. And that's the problem. So it's saying, instead of saying master, you say expert. And finally, of course, it's intonation, the pitch. If I talk in the same pitch, again, it becomes monotonous, boring. So what it is saying, vary the pitch. General suggestion which it is giving is really useful to everyone. Think of the keyword. So I'm going to say Teams Coach is the great feature. Before I speak that, Speaker Coach is the keyword. So now the correct way of saying that sentence is, in Teams, Speaker Coach is a very good feature. So what is the conclusion? Use this to your advantage. Now, how exactly do you use it? First of all, enable it for a few long meetings so you have not one, but many reports to look at. Then analyze the reports. Then identify areas of improvement. Create a meeting, a dummy meeting, where you are the only person speaking and practice the areas of improvement. These reports are completely private to you. Neither your boss, nor an IT person, nor Microsoft can see it. If you like what I said, please subscribe. Click on the bell icon, like the video, share it with your colleagues and loved ones. And most importantly, tell me what you liked, what you didn't like. Is there a topic I missed? Do you have any queries? I am happy to answer all of that.